Hi guys, Brett Williams from BretFX here. I've got a new freebie effect for you, Strobe. It's actually a set of four strobe plugins. The first one being your standard strobe effect here, where you can dial in the frames per second. It defaults to 6. And so that's giving you that nice stutter effect that kind of looks nice on action scenes like this water slide here. This is a 30 frames per second video, so if I were to dial it up to 30, it would look normal. You can go all the way up to 60, but there's no extra frames to... So anything beyond 30 is going to look the same. But what you have here, and as well as with the old strobe effect in Final Cut Legacy, is if you dial in some weird number like 14 frames a second on a 30 frames per second timeline, you're going to get like kind of a weird cadence. You know, may or may not be obvious depending on how much motion you have in your scene. 12 frames a second, you're going to have, there you can kind of see a weird judder going on because it's duplicating one frame for 3 and then another one for 2. So what I've done, let me delete that out, is I've given you 3 more plugins here called Smooth Cadence Strobe. And we're going to use the 30 frames per second one because it's a 30 frames per second sequence. And what that does is it limits you to the specific frame rates that are smooth. 15 frames a second. You know, anything that's multipliable, divisible by 30, I guess. 10 frames a second will repeat each frame 3 times. You know, 6 is going to repeat it 5 times. 5 frames a second is going to repeat it 6 times. You know, all the way down to just 1 frame a second. That is one heck of a strobe. And it's not extending or making the video any faster or longer. It's simply holding one frame for as many frames as necessary to create the necessary frame rate. And essentially skipping over the frames in between. Just a little effect that's been missing from Final Cut Pro 10, and a lot of people have published it, but they've just kind of published it right from motion, and it didn't quite make as much sense. The little slider just said strobe rate or strobe amount or something like that, and it actually is the frame rate that it's creating, whereas the old effect in Final Cut Legacy used to tell you how many frames it was going to hold for each frame. In the end, the same thing. You get the same result, except for, I think, adding these nice three little 24p, 30p, and 60p versions that lock you into specific smooth cadence frame rates keeps you from doing the math yourself. Just a little bonus. All right, well, that's all I got. You can download this at bretfx.com, where you can find other plugins and a few more freebies. Thanks for watching.